Now, next one is AND or invert gate. AND or AND invert. So AND or invert, which contains three functions. That is, one is AND function, second one is OR function, third one is invert function. Here you can see the first circuit diagram, that is AND and OR. Second one is NAND and NAND circuit. Third one is AND or invert. This is AND and this is OR, and finally we are getting here invert function. So now next one is positive and negative logic. What do you mean by positive logic and what do you mean by negative logic? Positive logic, normally we use in digital electronics, binary system. Binary system makes job 0 and 1. When you use 0 to represent low level voltage and when you use 1 to represent high level voltage, then it is called as positive logic. But when you use 0 to represent high level voltage and when you use 1 to represent low level voltage, then it is called as a negative logic. So depending on the type of logic, you will find positive OR gate equal to negative AND gate. So similarly, here you can see four types of relations are there. Positive OR is equal to negative AND. Positive AND is equal to negative OR. Positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. Positive NAND is equal to negative NOR. So you have to prove this one. For this one, so to prove this one, first of all, we will take here OR gate circuit, two input OR gate circuit, when A and B 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. So OR gate, we know when any one of the input is 1, output is 1. Now simply replace this 0 by 1 and 1 by 0 in the this truth table. So when you replace 0 by 1, 1 by 0, this becomes 1 1 1 0 0 1 and 0 0, and here it becomes 0, output becomes 0 0 and 1. So you can see here it is nothing but 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, AND gate. You see in this order, it is nothing but AND gate output. So what I can say, OR gate, positive OR is equal to negative AND. OR in positive logic is equivalent to AND in a negative logic. Is it clear? So like this, we have to prove the other relation also. Positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. That you have to prove. How to prove this one? Positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. First you write NOR. 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. What is the output for NOR? This is the output. 0 0 1 0 1 0. This is the output. Now replace 0 by 1 and 1 by 0. When you replace 0 by 1 and 1 by 0, you will get like this. That is nothing but NAND gate output. You just see like this. This is nothing but 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. This is the NAND gate output, like this NAND gate output. That means I can say once again, positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. Similarly, we have two more relations, that is so what we proved right now, we proved positive OR is equal to negative AND, positive NOR is equal to negative NAND. Similarly, in the exam, if they ask positive AND is equal to negative OR, positive NAND is equal to negative NOR, you can prove it. So very, very important. So next, assertion level logic. So we know assertion level logic, We know so far positive logic and negative logic. Now, most of the time, we use active low signals. For example, in the lab experiment, we use 8:1 multiplexer 74151. In 74151, pin number 7 is a strobe signal. So that is an active low signal. That means this active low signals without giving input 1, that means giving input 0, it causes the IC to be enabled. That means it causes some action to happen. So most of the designers, they define this type of active low signal with the bubble on the input or active low signal with the bubble on the output. So this type of signals are called as assertion level logic. Signals are asserted to cause certain action on the action or certain action. So this is called as assertion level logic. So next one is introduction to HDL. What do you mean by HDL? HDL is nothing but hardware description language. So hardware description language. So it is used to describe digital circuit. It is the textual description of digital circuits. So which is used for simulation of digital circuit. So in HDL, hardware description language, we are using two types. One is very log and other one is VHDL. So how you describe the circuit? So the input-output definition in Verilog HDL for logic circuits are explained something like this. This is the block diagram of the circuit. This is the block diagram where the inputs are where the input are A, B, C. Output is X and Y. In that case, we represent the circuit by module and end module. That is the entity module with the name and followed by input and output, then end module. After that, you have to define input and you have to define output, then body of the code or logic you have to define here. So that is the structure of a Verilog HDL. Now Verilog HDL has got three types of behaviors. One is called as gate level modeling. Second one is data flow modeling. Third one is first one is gate level modeling, second one is data flow modeling, third one is test bench. So now in gate level modeling, we define the circuit by using gates, but this is somewhat complicated. That's why what we do is this is somewhat complicated. Every time you call different gate function to implement the circuit diagram is complicated. That's why what we use, data flow modeling. In data flow modeling, we use some type of assign statements. By using assign statement, we will assign the logic and we'll use some type of operator like greater than, lesser than, logical and, logical or, etc. And next one is called as behavioral modeling. Behavioral modeling is nothing but a set of instructions are executed in sequential order like using if-else statement, etc. That is called as behavioral modeling. Last one is a test bench. Test bench is nothing but giving input in the form of a waveform to this circuit, which will call in turn particular function and implement and provides the output waveform. That is called as test bench. So this is about introduction to HDL. Now you see here, so Verilog circuits for simple Verilog code for simple circuit diagram, you can see here. So you can see here module. So this circuit is a particular name, and this circuit contains input and output. You have to separately define the input, separately define the output, and you have to call a gate function G1, G2 and G3. That is, first one is AND function, second one is AND function, third one is AND OR function, followed by AND module. So this we'll see once again here. So you can see here a simple OR gate, the code for simple OR gate, module AND module OR gate, A and B are the input, Y is the output. You have to define input, define output, and call OR function provided by gate followed by Y output and input. So you can use this one for writing like double slash for writing commands and AND module. This is the one circuit diagram for OR function. Second one is you can see here, this is the circuit diagram for figure 2.24, which is figure 2.24 here. You will see the figure 2.24. So it's not given properly, figure 2.24. Anyway, I will try to explain you here, figure 2.24, here it is something like A, B, C, D and Y. Input are A, B and C, D, and output is equal to Y, and in between outputs are wire and underscore O output 1 and underscore output 2. I will draw the circuit diagram for this one. So it is something like this. So this is A and this is B, and we have C and D, and this is connected to AND gate. So AND gate I will call, this is G1, understood? Then this is connected to AND gate. So this is G2, and output of this one is connected to OR gate. So output of this one is connected to OR gate. So this is G3 and this is Y. So now in between output, this we represent by using wire. So this I will call wire by using wire, and this I will call AND underscore output 1. That is output 1 of AND gate 1. AND underscore output 1. This is AND underscore output 2. AND underscore output 2. So like this it works. Normally in the exam they will give the circuit diagram and you have to write the code. So now you see the next one here. Write the code for this one. So what it contains? First, what you have to do? First you have to name the gate one. This one. This is gate G1. This is G2. This is G3. And this is G4. So we are using two OR gate and one NAND gate and one NOR gate. And in between this one, we have to use the wire. This is, I can say, this one we'll call OP underscore OR1. This one I'll call OP underscore OR2. And this is also OP underscore OR1. So like this, you have to define this one. Then the code is, you can see here the code, this is the code. So module end module. So please remember in the exam, don't do this mistake. This is the single word, end module. So give some name, input and output, define input, output, wire. What are the wires required? Then you have to call the function. I am calling two times OR function, one time NOR function, one time NAND function. OR function followed by gate name G1, G2, G3, G4 and output and input. Output and input. So in this way you have to this one.